given this table that represents a function, we want to determine the value of r, which is the missing output here when the input is positive 2. Then we need to write a function rule for the entire table. And just to review, these x values would represent the inputs into the function, also referred to as a domain. And the set of values in this column would be the outputs, called the range of the function. So to determine the value of r, the first thing we want to recognize is that if we look at the inputs, as we work our way down this column, notice that each of the inputs are increasing by 1. And now if we look at the corresponding outputs, notice from 8 to 4 is a decrease of 4, so we're subtracting 4 here. And from 4 to 0, we're subtracting 4. And from 0 to negative 4, we're subtracting 4. So by recognizing this pattern, we should be able to determine the value of r. If we have negative 4 and we subtract 4 again, this would give us the value of negative 8 for r. And let's see if the pattern continues. Negative 8 minus 4 does give us negative 12, so we can conclude that r is equal to negative 8. Now we want to see if we can write a function rule that would create this entire table. We did just finish studying linear equations, and this table does represent a linear relationship. So because of this, we can actually use the slope-intercept form of a line to help us determine the function rule for this table. So we'll use the form of a linear equation y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope and b is the y-intercept. Remember, f of x is equal to y. So by analyzing this table now, we should be able to determine the slope and the y-intercept. Remember, the slope is the ratio of the change of y to the change of x. Well, looking at our table, notice that the change of y is negative 4 when the change of x is positive 1. So if we have a negative 4 over positive 1, this tells us the slope would be negative 4. And since b is the y-intercept, which occurs when x is equal to 0, if we look at our table, notice that when x is 0, y is equal to 0. So this tells us that the y-intercept is equal to 0, and therefore b is equal to 0. So the linear equation in slope-intercept form that would produce this table would be y equals negative 4 times x, or negative 4x. And now we can write this using function notation by simply replacing y with f of x. So the function rule for this table would be f of x equals negative 4x. So whenever we have a table that's a linear relationship, we can write the equation in slope-intercept form and then write the equation as a function rule. And of course, we can test this if we want. With an input of negative 2, the output would be positive 8. That checks. If the input is negative 1, we'd have negative 4 times negative 1, which is positive 4, and so on. Okay, hope you found this helpful.